Ever feel like you need a microscope to click a button? Or that your fingers are all thumbs when trying to drag or swipe? Let's talk about how accessibility means making every interaction, whether it's a tap, click, or voice command, work for everyone. Welcome to What in the World is WCAG? 2.5 Input Modalities. Pointer Gestures. Have you tried to pinch to zoom or swipe with three fingers, only to have it not work the way you expected? I struggle every time I try to open the rotor on my iPhone. It's supposed to be simple, but it feels like finger gymnastics. I can play the piano, but I can't open the rotor consistently. For many users, these complex gestures can be frustrating or even impossible to perform. Multi-finger gestures require fine motor skills that not everyone has, as evidenced by me. Users with mobility challenges or those using assistive technologies can struggle with gestures that involve more than one point of contact on the screen. Pointer gestures ensures that important actions can be performed with simpler gestures, like a single tap or click, instead of relying on complicated swipes, pinches, or rotations. Pointer cancellation. We've all been there, just about to click, then suddenly change our minds. Maybe you were about to tap a link but realized it wasn't the right one. Pointer cancellation is all about making sure that users can back out of an action before it's completed. Here's how it works. When you press down on a button or link, that's the down event, but the action shouldn't be finalized until you release your finger, which is the up event. If you change your mind while holding down, you should be able to move your finger away and not trigger anything. It's the same with your mouse, and why double clicking is still so common. This might seem small, but it prevents accidental clicks and taps, especially for users with motor impairments or those using touchscreens. Undo is also an important feature, including using the backspace or delete keys on the keyboard. Label in name. Imagine seeing a shopping cart icon on a website. You might call it basket, shopping basket, cart, or even trolley. But if the accessible name for that icon doesn't match what you see, or what you'd naturally say, it can create barriers for users relying on voice commands. So add some text and match the label to it. It's better for everyone. Quick note, when it comes to voice commands, the first word is the one that matters most. So if you have a shopping basket with a close button, you might want additional information to be given to assistive technology users, so you can have close basket and continue shopping as an ARIA label. Just match up that first word with the visible text. Motion actuation. I was on a bus the other day and the ride was so bumpy that it kept triggering my phone's shake to undo feature over and over again. It was beyond irritating. Motion actuation ensures that actions triggered by physical movements like shaking, tilting, or rotating a device aren't the only option for interacting with content. While motion gestures can be convenient in some cases, they can also cause problems, especially for users with motor impairments or anyone, like me on that bus, who just can't rely on their environment to keep things steady. To make things accessible, users should always have alternatives, like tapping a button or using a voice command, so they can perform actions in ways that work for them. Whether it's shaky hands, a shaky bus, or a preference for more control, offering alternative methods ensures that motion-based features don't become barriers. Dragging movements. You might not think twice about dragging and dropping, whether it's reordering slides in a presentation, moving tasks around on a Kanban board, or dragging a pin across an online map. But dragging movements requires a surprising amount of fine motor control, and for some users, that just isn't possible. The solution? Simple. Your drag and drop functionality should work with point and click. Instead of clicking, holding, and moving an item across the screen, users can click or tap once to select the item, then click or tap again to place it where they want. If it's a map that you can move around to view it, add some arrow buttons to move it up, down, left, or right. Target size, minimum, and enhanced. Have you ever clicked the wrong button on a form because they were too small or too close together? That's a common frustration for many users, especially on mobile devices. The two target size criteria address this issue by defining minimum and recommended sizes for clickable elements like buttons and links. The key number to remember is 24 pixels. This is the minimum target size to ensure that interactive elements are easier to tap or click. Think of it as giving users more breathing room when selecting options. This isn't just about aesthetics, it's about making sure users can accurately tap what they want without accidentally hitting something else. But what if your design calls for smaller buttons? There's still some flexibility. If your buttons are smaller than 24 pixels, you can still meet the minimum requirement by adding enough padding around them to reach that 24 pixel minimum. This ensures that users can still interact comfortably, even if the visible button itself is smaller. But is that actually good in practice? This is from Bunny Comics. Bunny is tapping away at the top corner, but nothing is happening, so they get out a microscope and a stylus to poke at it more directly. Since the tapping wasn't activating something else, this might actually fit within the rules. So remember, just because you can, doesn't mean you should. Speaking of should, WCAG has a AAA version, Target Size Enhanced. At 44 pixels, we ensure even more accessible interactions, so aim for that. Whether it's buttons, links, or drop-down menus, the key takeaway is simple. Make interactive elements big enough and spaced well enough for everyone to use easily. After all, no one ever complained that something was too easy to click. Input modalities. Because it shouldn't matter how you click, tap, type, or talk.